Hello and welcome you all in this session. Myself, Assistant Professor Ripa Gupta from LG School of Law. Today we'll discuss the subject of legal theory, in which I'm going to teach you on the topic of Historical School of Law. Historical School of Law, like its name, it has its nature. Historical School of Law talks about the history, that whatever we are doing since many years, that we have followed since many years, become the present legal system. That it says that history is a legal source of law. In present times, we are following certain laws because we are doing this since many years. So now that became our habit. So now we'll treat it as a legal system. So Historical School of Law, it talks about the system that are there in the society since many years, and people are following it and become habituated to that system, and now that system turned into a law. Legislature adopted the system and made the laws. So this is about the concept of Historical School of Law. Savin is the main propounder of this school. He says that, of course, he is against the Austin theory of sovereignty. So he says that there is no top-down system. Anything that that is related to law is self-evolved. We evolve the law. We people, for our goodness, we evolve the law. So there is no top-down system. No one can make laws for the other. We make laws for us. So depending on this system, Savini propounded the theory of Historical School of Law. According to him, Historical School of Law, why it is a good source of law? Because he says that we are following certain systems since many years, and now we become habituated to the system, and then we adopted the system in our legal system. So this become a Historical School of Law. Like our customs, we follow customs even though they are in written form or not, but we are following it. So this becomes our habits, and then we turn it into legal, we give him the legal nature. For example, our customs are rituals related to marriage or family, whatever that is, because we are following it for many years and now it becomes our habit. So this is the way where Savini tries to talk about Historical School of Law, that something that is lies in history since many years, we are following it, and now it is becomes our habit to follow it, and then for adopting it in a better way, we make a law for it. So this is about Historical School of Law. The Historical School of Law describes the various stages of development of law. It does not talk about only past, but it talks about it knits together past and present together. How past can be applied in present time? So this is about Historical School of Law. How is that? First example, it talks about customs, that customs are being followed by since many years, and now they are being applicable for our easement, so that we can make a legal system on it. But there are some situation also which give rise to a law. First example, we have personal laws, which are, of course, we came from our customs. We followed them from many years. So now we have the these as a law. But now this law, we come from the history, but it has a existence in present time. So now, for example, Shahbano case, where Supreme Court contended that even a Muslim woman can have a right of maintenance. So this gives a rise to a new legal system through the history, that even though from history Muslim women were not able to take maintenance, but now in today's time we need to change this theory. So now we have to give them maintenance. So he says that from history you can have your own legal system. You can knit together that present time and past time, and you can apply it in present while learning experiences. So Historical School of Law is all about learning experiences, that is self-evolved law, that you evolve through custom or through the situations, that you evolve certain laws. This becomes the Historical School of Law. So Savini has propounded historical school of law, and to support his historical school of law, he promoted one more theory and the concept that is called Volkagist. So for supporting his theory, he propounded one more theory, that is Volkagist theory. Volkagist theory talks about the general consciousness of the people. He says that why we follow certain things, because we have general consciousness about that. For example, we believe in our personal laws, we believe in our customs. It is a general consciousness of the people behind that system, behind that custom. So then we make it as a law, we adopt that custom as a law. So this is about Volkagist, that is talking about general consciousness or a general acceptance of the people on one custom or one system that give rise to a one law. So but that has to be followed by many years, that is comes from the history, it comes from the habits of the people, it is self-evolved system of people that they believe in it, that is a Volkagist, that is a concept of historical school of law. Now this school is also talks about the development of law in the stages. It does not talk about only the history, but talks about the present too. But it says that present come from the experiences of history, that we are having today personal laws, but we made changes in the personal laws. Why? Because we have experiences certain things. For example, we had system of sati, we had system of dowry, now we abolished it. So because through the experiences we learned it, through the experiences of past we learned it. So it says that it's a stages of law, a development of law through which we propound one legal system. So from history we learn something, we experience something, and then we make a law. So it says that from historical experiences we make laws for the present time, because we learned it, we feel, we experienced it. So from that we have a good legal system by our learning experience. This is historical school of law, which talks about development of law also. 70 says that law grows with the growth of people, it develops with society. First example, we are not believing in the inter-caste marriages in the past, but now we believe in LGBT rights too. So this is how we are evolved, how this we developed our legal system. So but we even today take our decision from our past customs, even LGBT rights or inter-caste marriages or triple talak abolition, whatever it is, that we study is the past, whether that customs were proper or not. So this school gives you the development, or makes understand the development of law, how the law develops. Law develops for by the people, by their self-evolved system. They changes and they make the changes in the legal system. This is about historical school of law. So today we have discussed historical school of law, which talks propounded by the Savini. And Savini believes that history is self-evolved, and it is self-evolved system through which we can develop law for the present time. And to support this theory, he propounded one more theory, that is Volkagist theory. It talks about the general consciousness of the people for setting up a one system. So basically, historical school of law says that we learn something from the history, our historical experiences, and we can apply in the present time. So it is a development of law. It makes understand the stages of development of law. Thank you.